Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel where we dive deep into the latest features of .NET and Blazor. Today, I am super excited to introduce Constructor Injection in Blazor Component, a game-changing feature in .NET 9. Now, if you have been working with Blazor, you know that up to .NET 8, we have primarily relied on property injection to inject services into our component. But think about this, have you ever encountered weird initialization issues in your component where services aren't available right when you need them? Or maybe you have had trouble ensuring that your dependencies are injected in a consistent or predictable order? Well, that is where Constructor Injection in .NET 9 shines. When you use Constructor Injection, you can initialize these services right when your component is created, guaranteeing that everything is in place before the first render. This makes your component faster, safer, and easier to test. Maybe you might be saying that, well, I have this initialize lifecycle, so I can initialize or I can inject my services in the initialize cycle. Well, you can do that. But think about this. Component gets first created before it performs its first rendering. That is where it initializes. Now, in the component creation, that is where Constructor works. So if you have your service injected in the Constructor, it tells you that as soon as the component is created, or even during the creation of your component, this service also injected. And that is the best thing that you can do to help you skip all null checks in your services in your Blazor component. Let's see how we can integrate this. Now let's create a simple Blazor project. So launch of Visual Studio 2022, and you must make sure that you have .NET 9 installed. So all that you need to do here is update your Visual Studio installer to get the latest .NET 9. Okay, so we're going to choose Blazor web app, and here let me give it demo. I'm going to say constructor injection and Blazor. All right, so I have a location set already. Now click on next. So we choose the interactive. It could be server, it could be auto, it could be WebAssembly. Let's maintain the server. Now let's create this project. So now that our project is created, let's go to our solution and let's navigate to one of the components. So we're going to open the pages folder, and we have this home component. So let's use this for this demo. So we're going to create a code behind file to handle this. Okay, so I'm going to click this pages folder. Then I'm going to create a class. I'm going to name it as home, because this class is going to be a partial class to this home, so I can separate my UI from the code. So home.cs, and it is the same name as this component. So if you want to separate your code base from your UI, that is what you must do. And this should be a public partial since it is part of the home component. You make it as public partial class, then give it the name as home as you have it in the as a component name. Okay, so normally in .NET 8 and below, if you want to inject any service, anything at all, you need to use this inject attribute, isn't it? Let's see. Now I'm having an API running, so we want to make a call to this service. Let's assume you're making a call to an external service. So in order for me to get connected or communicate to the API that I have, I need to create a simple model to handle that. And that is a class which has two properties of ID and number. Okay, in property injection, we need to use this inject attribute, and that is what we have been doing. So if you want to, since you're going to be making a call, we need an HTTP client, isn't it? So normally when using .NET 8 and below, you need to have this inject attribute. You now go ahead and specify, let's say this is protected. Then you say this is an HTTP client. Then you say this is client. Let's say we want to set the base address of this. Here, we cannot set this base address when this component is created, unless this component has done with the creation. And during the initialization, that is where we can set the base address of this. But when you have your override, then uninitialize. So that is where you can go ahead and now set the base address. So let's say you can say that this HTTP client service dot base address, then this equal to have new URI that you can now pass in the address. So here you cannot set the base address when the component is creating. You can do that after the component has created. Now, in case you have any method that you want to call as soon as the component is created, then this HTTP client will be null. That is the base address, because during the creation error, the client here is null. It doesn't have any base address. But with the help of constructor injection, you can now have this set. Let's see. So with the constructor injection, you don't need to be using this property injection. All that you're going to do here is you can create a constructor here. Then you need to specify HTTP client here. Control period. We can create an assigned field. After assigning this, you can go ahead, grab this, and now set it here. So one good thing about this constructor injection to here, it helps you remove or release the loads of this initialize lifecycle. So all these are happening in the constructor. Before the or during the creation of this component, that is also going to have access. And now the address is going to be set. So after the component has created, HTTP client will be having its base address. So you can go ahead and I make a call in the first rendering here and I get response. This is my address. So you can see that from here, after the component gets created, I am setting my base address. Now, even after I am done setting this base address, I can even make a call in the constructor. See what you're going to do. So in the constructor, I'm going to assign this. After assigning this, I'm going to set the base address. Then I'm going to make a call. All these are going to happen in the creation process. So after the component is created, when I come to division, by then, division here, this list here, has got its record or data from the API. So I can go in there and create another variable known as public. So this is going to be public divisions. And here I can go ahead and now take some of the records which have been held here during the construction process. So I can just take maybe three of them. And I will see from here the load or the number of code that you're writing here, it is less, isn't it? Because all the work have been done here. So let's go ahead and now display this. So in the UI, we can go and create a simple UI to display that. Let's run this and check it out. So we are having an issue here because we forgot to register this HTTP client. And I think registering this is quite simple. All that you need to do here is to have your beta.services.addHttpClient, and that is all. And yeah, you can see we have the records from the API. So the take here is, if you want to make this service available during the creation process, then use constructor injection. But if you want to make it available after the component has been created, then you can go ahead and use the property injection, which is what we have been using since. But well, since we have an introduction of the constructor injection, which has more advanced features than the property injection, I think we should go for the new one. Well, so now that you understand this, you can make a choice and integrate the best for your scenario. All right, so I believe you've learned something here. Thank you for watching this, and hopefully stay tuned for more updates in .NET 9 as well. All right, catch up again. Take care.